Alright, how's it going, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Taylor, and if it's your first time here, I really appreciate you guys watching this video. Today we are going to do some BMW stuff, some BMW content. So first off, I gotta change some rotors, so a little brake maintenance for the BMW, but I do have one major repair for you guys, and today we are going to do the oil adapter housing gasket. So pretty much where your canister filter is, it bolts onto the block with like three aluminum bolts. I think they're like E6s or something like that. The N51s and the N52, or I think it's N52. Don't quote me on it. But anyways, the oil adapter housing gasket is like notorious for constantly blowing. You guys know how BMWs are. They run hot. They just do. And it's got a coolant port right there, right next to it. And I busted it a while back, so the car's been constantly leaking coolant, or asking for coolant, excuse me. So we're gonna go ahead and finally get that done today, and change the rotors on the front of the car, and yeah, let's get started. I don't mind. Going to jack up the car. Someone's been snagging my lug nuts in this park. No bueno. No bueno. Alright, so we need to pull this off. It's pretty simple. Get a screwdriver right here and just lift out. Once we pull that off, we can pull off the caliper, and then I will pull off the mounting bracket, unscrew the rotor bolt, and it'll come right off. Alright, give me a couple seconds. Go behind here, pull these plugs out. There's one on top, one on the bottom. I believe it's a T30, don't quote me on it, but we'll go ahead and pull those out. It's actually T45. Ideally, you shouldn't let these hang, but we'll be all right. Thank you. for the rotor. Rubber mallet. There we go. Just like that. Do you guys see how this rotor is like two different sizes? Yeah, it's pretty ugly, huh? It's not really supposed to be like that. And the edges is all rigid. So it's time to replace this. Time for the new box. Alright, when you put these on, they're usually coated with some anti-rust shit or whatever. Use some brake cleaner and clean them off both sides, and then go ahead and reinstall. Now it's time to pull out the brake pads, and then we are going to compress the piston with a special tool. It's a brake compressor. Usually pretty cheap. You can usually get them from O'Reilly's for like 30 bucks. That one is Cornwall, so it's a little bit more expensive. But yeah, pull the brake pads out of the caliper, and yeah, we're gonna decompress them. Oh, sorry, didn't mean to hit y'all. Now that the caliper's back on, let's go ahead and tighten it up. Ooh. gloves are on, put the caps back on. Then we'll put this back on. Just like that. Rotor replace. Butte. Time to put the wheel back on. Heaven forbid it's got three fucking lug nuts, so. Need to go buy a kit. We're gonna get under the car and you see this right here, that blue thing is the drain plug. You're gonna take a Phillips in there, start unscrewing it, and yeah, looks like I got some fittings that are starting to wear out, so I will need to replace those. On a side note, that's another day. At least I know where it's leaking. We're gonna need a big flathead. Well, there was no cooling in there. This BMW's running hot. Hot. Not a good sign. But also, I'm glad I'm doing this before I had to worry about anything blowing on me. Because I would be sad. Okay. That's crazy, because one little leak, one blow in there, and you can start freaking mixing coolant and oil. And that's never any fun. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take, usually people take off this fitting, I don't. Sometimes these are prone to breaking. It happens, just be careful. Go 10 mil and then you'll wiggle it off. 10 mils. Now that those are out, be careful wiggling it out. And that is what it looks like. But time to take the oil filter out. And I got a handy dandy band wrench. Just like that, use the band wrench. Pull that thing out. Just like that. Now, it's time to go ahead and safely pull the Torx out. So we're looking at like an E6, I think. Could be wrong. What is this? E10? I lied, it's an E10. Alright, this camera real quick. Okay. Alright, so quick tip. You see these right here? These are aluminum bolts. Now, most people will say to replace them, but I fucking don't. Just, they stretch because they're aluminum. Usually aluminum don't really stretch though, depending on how hot it gets. Don't quote me on it. But I'm using the same ones. If you want, go ahead and change them, really up to you. Most people recommend it, so I'm gonna tell you to go ahead and change them, but for me, not going to. All right, so we got the bolt out here, we got the bolt out here, and now there's one kind of under the intake. It is easier to pull out this air box and this hose line, but you do it however you feel is most comfortable. I'm gonna be going ahead and taking out this air box for me. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do that. All right, that bolt was a bitch, but let me tell you something. If you have a 12 point and just a little 8 mil, a lot of people will say going through here, obviously not working. A good way is just to go in here and there's enough space to break it. So Go through that little gap right here. There's just enough space. But now that that's off, we're gonna go ahead and pull it off. All right, see, this right here is what it looks like. There's the oil, and here is the gasket. As you can tell, it's been breaching. Looks like it breached right there, there, and there. And coolant, my friends, is what cools this oil. Your coolant lines actually route inside of this housing where your air filter's at to help keep the motor cool. And so when that gasket shits out, your oil and your coolant start mixing like a motherfucker. That's pretty notorious with these E90s and shit, but yeah. So we'll take that black gasket out of there, clean it up real good, use some brake cleaner, and then go ahead and put the new gasket in and seal and tighten everything up. Okay, so brake cleaner. Don't spray brake cleaner on the surface. Spray brake cleaner on the rag, then clean it. It's all cleaned up with the new gasket. Now it's gonna go back on there. And hopefully, not hopefully, no more mixing fucking coolant. Ooh. Thank God. Now we're gonna take this. And we're gonna put this in the bolt pattern first. And then we'll drop the stuff on there. That way it's just easier for everything to go in properly in terms of the screw. Cause if you try and put this, like I said, when you're putting the oil filter housing back on, make sure the screw is in the housing already and then place it back on there, because otherwise it's a pain in the ass to fish the bolt in there. But once you do that, go ahead and tighten everything down. What did I just do? Oh. Yeah. Take your 8mm. Go in this corner again. Now, it's time for the oil filter. Personal reference or preference, Wicks, or I don't know, Quicks or I don't know. I don't really like really have a preference. Wicks or K&M. Well, this time around, I got K&M because only because they didn't have Wicks. So you'll get O-rings and a washer for the boat. We need your oil change. Going downstairs. So what you'll do is go right here and pull out this O-ring on the canister. Oh no. Oil on my iPhone. No bueno. Bing. Bada boom, bada bing. Canister. Give it a little twist. That'll definitely help. For my BMW, there's usually like an inner piece that goes inside of here, and it's usually got like a nipple. I think the last person that had this car accidentally threw it away, or fucking if they took it to oil or Jiffy Lube or someplace that does oil changes, I think they either broke it or just threw it away. But there's a little piece on here that sticks out, and it's got like a little O-ring on the end of it right here, and that's what it's for. If you're following this video and you open up your canister and you guys see that in there, you'll know what I'm talking about. But for now, I can't do nothing about it, so. Hand tighten it, then band wrench it. And wrench tight. Go put these sons of bitches back on. Because I took them off. Alright, we'll pop this back in there, reconnect our fittings. Now it's time to put the air box back in. Hose is hooked up. Now, come down here. Make sure you plug your sensor back in. All right. Now it's time to get under there and drain your oil. It's pretty easy. I'll show these guys how to do it. My wrench is down there, but let's also get a light so motherfuckers can see. oil. Pretty simple. That's right. Right there. Oh, I think it's a 17. Open it, drain it, close it. Simple. Then you fill. I always use Castrol on BMWs. Use Castrol Edge, high mileage, full synthetic. I think it's high mileage. Maybe not, but this is supposedly their new stuff and it's supposed to be good. I usually put in about 6 quarts. Don't really matter if I overfill it. Thing burns oil like a motherfucker. Well, that's BMWs for you. Time for the coolant. Make sure you clean out your little funnel real nice. And you always want to go blue. I got O'Reilly's brand. Usually you want to go from the dealer. Dealer's always got the best coolant. But I cheaped out. Talk shit if you want. I don't really care. Clean it out real good. Put that right there and fill it up. Xerox 5050. Now, whenever you drain coolant, you gotta bleed it. And I'll show you guys how to do that. Alright, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna turn your heat on. Just like that, all the way max. Push on the gas pedal with the engine on. And you're gonna hold down the gas pedal for about 12 seconds. And then, your shit should be kicking on. You come back over here and look inside of your pump and you should see a little stream. And once that's complete, your system is bled. You hear it? Yeah. Now mine's got a little bit of oil in there. I'm gonna have to flush it again in a couple days because of that gasket fucking up. But other than that, that's how you do it. If you guys like this video, please comment, subscribe, follow your boy. Peace, guys.